We congratulate the Workers' Party on their victory here tonight, and we commiserate the losers, including the People's Action Party. We made this a referendum on national issues, and the debate on national issues will continue long after the excitement over this result has died down. Of course, this election was mainly fought on local or municipal issues, and clearly the control of the town council by the MP is an obstacle to democracy. I will now read a brief statement that I have prepared. Okay. I'll speak up now.
Yep.
Okay, I'm going to read a prepared statement. Yeah. On the 16th of January 2000, the Reform Party changed the political landscape in Singapore for the second time. The first time was in 2011, when Singapore's first totally new party in 20 years was formed and fought the general election. We changed the political landscape on that day by demonstrating to Singaporeans the only fit and proper objective. Truly able to hold the government accountable, and that requires the right kind of candidate. These candidates must be electable and not turn up physically or in the media or cyberspace just during the election period in order to benefit from the free media attention. By electable, we are not referring to academic qualifications. Singapore's national pledge promises to build a democratic society, and candidates must be sincere in wanting to fulfill that. That is all that matters. We have also shown that elections must not be fought merely on pork barrel politics, that the issues causing hardship are not restricted to municipal ones, on the running of town councils. That view distracts the voter into favouring the biggest, best resourced and longest surviving party, and denies new blood, competition and choice. The only goal is to sincerely desire to give Singaporeans a better life now and in the future. Merely by entering this contest with a credible candidate and superior policies, irrespective of the polling results, we have taken the first step in mending the biggest broken promise of all, which was the promise to build a democratic society and all that that entailed. Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Of course, it was brought back to local issues, but the control of the town council by the MP is unfortunately an obstacle to democracy.
Right. Kenneth, your campaign slogan of no more broken promises, to what extent do you think it has gone down well with the voters here?
Well, I think that our attack on the PAP clearly resonated and resulted in many people voting tactically. We don't care if we have lost our deposit tonight, which I'm not confirming at the moment. It's a small price to pay for democracy, and we don't care how many deposits we lose if we achieve that goal.
Right.
Thank
now,
you.
This result, Kenneth, what is the greatest and most significant takeaway for your party?
As I said, we don't care how much we lose in the struggle for democracy, and that we won't stop till we've achieved that goal.
Kenneth, next general election, will the Reform Party, will you be standing in Punggol East again? Are you here to stay?
I can't confirm that I will be standing here, but we will certainly be here to stay.
Thank you very much.
Are you surprised at the result? Are you disappointed that we actually garnered?
As I said, we don't care how many deposits we lose, if the end result is democracy.
So you're actually not concerned that the percentage not a cause of concern?
No, I mean, we played a major role in attacking the PAP, and they should be much more concerned. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Mr. Kenneth, what are your plans for tomorrow?
Our plan for tomorrow, I think I will catch some rest and then we will decide what to do then. Thank you.
What about thanking the voters? Yeah. Would that be an official activity to thank the voters?
We should do, but we'll have to get back to you on that. Thank you. Mm-hmm.